Yogena chittasya padena vacham malam sharirasya cha vaityakena yopakarotam pravaram muninam patanjalim pranjaliranatusmi patanjalim pranjaliranatusmi patanjalim pranjaliranatusmi. Hello friends, this is the sixth video on the web series on Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. Welcome to this video. Let's start this video with a story. Once upon a time, there was a wise lady. Her name was Gonika. She was a yogini. One day, she was offering her prayers to the sun god with water in her palms. She said to the Lord, God, I have so much wisdom to share, but I have no baby to bear. Please give me a baby so that this wisdom can be shared. It's a poem. I made a poem. So she's praying this way. Then she brought all her hopes and wishes and she made this wish to have a baby so that her wisdom can be passed. And when she opened her eyes to offer this water, she saw something wriggling in her palms. There was a tiny snake there wriggling there, which just jumped out and took a human form. She named the baby Patanjali. This is the story that goes behind the birth of Patanjali. Now, when Patanjali visited this universe, yoga existed already. The knowledge of yoga was in various pockets of various texts. Patanjali took the gist of all this, essence of all this, practiced it, experienced it, and then the whole essence he put forth in this 195 Yoga Sutras. Friends, we have so many locks in us. Patanjali has given this 195 keys. We need not go through all these 195 Yoga Sutras if we find the right key. So, to know the key, we have to read this 195 Yoga Sutras. They are like formulas. So we find our formula for our lock, we find the key. What Patanjali did was, he then took this 195 Yoga Sutras and passed it from student to student to student. That was known as Guru Shishya Parampara. Now, he divided this Yoga Sutras into four chapters. The first chapter he named it as Samadhipad. It has 51 Yoga Sutras. It's like a trailer of a movie in which everything that can be achieved in this human life is given. All the various samadhis are given and hence the name Samadhipad. It is said by various commentators and scholars that this first chapter is for the very higher level of yogis. The second chapter is called as Sadhanapad and it has 55 sutras. Kriya Yoga, the concept of Sanyog and the concept of Ashtanga is there in this Sadhanapad. So what to do is explained in this second chapter, which has 55 sutras. The third chapter, the name of which is Vibhutipad, it has 55 sutras too. 55 sutras and the sutras are dedicated to Dharana, Dhyan, Samadhi, the concept of Sayam, and various Vibhutis are discussed in this. The fourth chapter has 34 sutras. It is the smallest chapter and the name is Kaivalyapad. The concept of Nirmana Chitta is explained there and also the concept of Karmashaya, clearing of the Karmashaya, and also what is Kaivalya and how to reach there is explained in the Kaivalyapad. So how do we remember it is 51, 55, 55 and 34. That makes it 195 Yoga Sutras. Some people say there are 196 sutras, some people say there are 194 sutras, some people say there are 197 sutras. The whole confusion is because in the third chapter, that is Vibhutipad, some of Vyasa's commentaries are taken as sutras. But when we study Vyasa Bhashya, we realize that he has given commentary on this 195 Yoga Sutras. So many of the authors, many of the commentators, many of the scholars feel, yes, it is 195 Yoga Sutras. So let's study them in this web series one by one. So the next video what we are going to deal is the first sutra, Atha Yoga Anushasanam from Samadhipad. And there we go, we are going to start with the Yoga Sutras, the first Yoga Sutra in the next video. My dear friends, be with this web series and learn the Yoga Sutras. It is surely going to change your life. Thank you so much.